हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन आर हिस्ट्री लेक्चर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 7 चैप्टर नंबर 9, दैट नेम इज द मेकिंग ऑफ रीजनल कल्चर्स। सो व्हाट आर अवर रीजनल कल्चर्स फ्रॉम द एंशियंट, दैट ऑल द थिंग्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर्स। सो लेट्स वी विल स्टार्ट अबाउट इट। The making of regional cultures. India's diverse regional languages and various festivals, different dance forms and music, dresses and food items evolved during the medieval age. So in this lesson we will study some of the historical process which shaped the regional cultures of India. What we understand as regional cultures? Today we are often the product of complex process of intermixing of the local traditions with ideas from other parts of the subcontinent. The Cheras and the development of Malayalam. Now in this first point we will see about the Cheras and the development of Malayalam. So what it shows? That it shows the connection between language and regions. The Chera dynasty of Kerala had links with the Pandyas. And actually, dynasty of Tamil Nadu. Till 8th century, Malayalam, the local language of Kerala, was influenced by the Tamil. After this, Brahmins migrated to Kerala. उसके बाद ब्राह्मण लोग उनमें migrate हो गए and built their temples which became the centers of Sanskrit learning. Around the 9th century, Kerala came under the rule of new Chera rulers, that is called as the Pyramids, who set up the capital at Mahodayapuram. Under the pyramids, the influence of Sanskrit on the Malayalam, it is increased. The first literary work in Malayalam dated to about 12th century. It is directly indebted to Sanskrit. Leela Tilakam, a 14th century work on Malayalam grammar, was written in the Malabar Bala style, which shows the growing influence of Sanskrit on Malayalam. Manibala means a combination of a gem with coral. The gem refers to the Trivellian language, which in this case is Malayalam, and coral represents the Sanskrit. Now next point is that religious worship in Orissa. So religion cultures grew around regional traditions. The best example of this process is the cult of Jagannath. अब इसका एक अच्छा example है कि जगन्नाथ cult जो पुरी में है, which is in the Odisha. Lord Shiva was widely worshipped in Odisha till the rise of Ganga dynasty in the 12th century, and the Varian began building the famous Jagannath Temple at Puri. The temple was probably completed by his son. The Jagannath Temple was highly respected by the people of Odisha. So, all the conquerors of Odisha protected its interest in the Jagannatha. It is believed to be a tribal deity who came to be identified with Lord Krishna along with the Jagannatha of his brother Balabhadra and sister Subhadra are also worshipped. मतलब ये जो तीन आइडल है यहाँ पे विच इज कार्ड लोगोज ऑफ वुड ऑन विच लार्ज आइज वेयर पेंटेड द फेमस रथ यात्रा फेस्टिवल इज सेलिब्रेटेड एनुअली इन जून. इनकी जो यात्रा है वो जून और जुलाई में होती है. व्हेन थ्री वुडन रथ्स बेयरिंग द आइडल्स आर ड्रॉन इन procession through the streets of Puri. Next is that the Kathak dance from the North India. अब ये कथक dance जो है वो कैसे आया? It is derived from the Katha word used in the Sanskrit and other language for story. The Katha कार्स मतलब जैसे हम कथा बताते हैं उससे ये कथा आया. विच इज वेयर कास्ट ऑफ स्टोरी टेलर्स इन द टेम्पल्स मंदिर में स्टोरी बताने वाले ऑफ नॉर्थ हु परफॉर्म्ड विद द गेस्चर्स एंड सॉन्ग्स ड्यूरिंग द भक्ति मूवमेंट कथा बिकेम इंक्रीजिंगली बेस्ड ऑन द स्टोरीज फ्रॉम लाइफ ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा. The legends of Radha Krishna were enacted in folk plays called the Ras Leela under the Mughal emperor and nobles. Kothak was performed in the courts. मतलब कौन सा डांस कब किया जाता था? Where it is acquired its present features and developed a distinctive style of dance form under the patronage of rulers like Nawab Wajid Ali Shah of Bhind in Uttar Pradesh. Several regional gharanas or schools of Kathak developed among these were the Jaipur Gharana of Rajasthan and the Banaras and Lucknow Gharanas of Uttar Pradesh. Kathak was viewed with disfavor by most of the British administrators. However, it survived and continued to be performed by courtesans and it was recognized as one of six classical forms of dance after independence. Other dance forms that are recognized as classical at present are at night time Tamil Nadu, Odisha, Manipuri, Odisha Manipuri and Manipuri Kathakali, Kerala and Kuchipudi, Andhra, Andhra Pradesh. Now, next we will see that the Rajput and the tradition of heroism. So, in the 9th century, the region that constitutes present-day Rajasthan was called Rajputana by the British. It may suggest the area was inhabited by the Rajasthan or Rajputs. मतलब ब्रिटिश के द्वारा इन्हें रजपुताना कहा जाता था. But it is only partly true. There are several people other than Rajputs who live in Rajasthan. However, the Rajputs are often recognized as contributing to distinctive culture of Rajasthan. The Rajputs preserved the stories of their heroism, loyalty, friendship, and love in the popular ballads and songs. Young Rajputs were trained in the art of warfare and were expected to follow the examples set by these stories. They preferred death than to fleeing from battlefield. They also guarded the honor of their women. Folk women were also depicted as falling. Their heroic husband in both life and death. There are stories about the practice of the sati or emulation. आपको सती प्रथा के बारे में पता होगा. So emulation of the videos on the funeral prayer of their husband. So those who followed the heroic idol often had to pay for it with their lives paintings. So now we will see about the paintings in the medieval period. So paintings in the medieval period, many rulers and nobles promoted the painting of miniature, small-sized paintings. The paintings were made of different materials like paper, cloth, wood, ivory, and leather. The paints used were of natural dyes made from vegetables and minerals. मतलब तब जो कलर यूज किए जाते थे वो minerals और बाकी जो vegetables थे उससे. So including the gold and silver, in the early medieval period, miniatures depicted religious then. The place of Bengal patronized the use of miniature. Miniature मतलब mini painting. And it illustrated Buddhism, while in the Western India, miniatures which were used to decorate the Jain manuscripts during the Sultanate period. Miniatures were used in the book illumination. The Mughals introduced new themes depicting court scenes, battle, natural landscapes, etc. तो मुगलों ने क्या किया कि अलग अलग जो scenes है वो उन्हें miniature paintings में लाने के लिए बताया. So whom I brought two famous painters, Mir Sayyid Ali and Abdul Samad from Persia, who founded the first school of Mughal miniature paintings in India. The Mughal emperors Akbar, Jahangir and Shahaji patronized highly skilled painters who primarily illustrated manuscripts containing historical accounts and poetry. Aurangzeb's dislike for painting led to the migration of painters from Mughal court to the different places such as Rajasthan, Kangra and the Deccan. Different styles of miniature paintings developed in the different regions. The Pahari style of painting developed in the hills extending from Jammu to Garhwal. The sultans of Deccan patronized the Deccan style of miniature painting. Next point is development in the medieval Bengal. So medieval Bengal often tend to identify regions in the term of the language spoken by the people. So we assume that people in the Bengal always spoke Bengali. However, it is interesting to note that while Bengali is now recognized as a language derived from Sanskrit, मतलब Bengali language भी Sanskrit से आई हुई है. Early Sanskrit text suggest that the people of Bengal did not speak Sanskrit language under the patronage of Muslim rulers of Bengal. Several authors translated the Ramayana and Mahabharata into Bengali from Sanskrit. Kirta versus Suja translated the Ramayana and Shri Quran, and I translated parts of Mahabharata into Bengali. In fact, by the 15th century, the Bengali group of dialects came to be united by a common literary language based on the spoken language of the western part of the region, now known as it is the West Bengal. Thus, although the Bengali is derived from the Sanskrit, it passed through several stages of the evolution. Early Bengali literature may be divided into two categories. One is indebted to Sanskrit and the other is independent of the first includes of Bhakti literature like the biographies. Biographies of Chaitanya Deva, the leader of Rational Bhakti. Rational Bhakti movement, the second includes not literature. The not font is composed two types of literature which were passed on orally. One was in the form of instructive verses partly in code language meant for cult members. The other was in the form of stories. They include epics, poems called the Mangal Kuvira, so called because even listening to these stories is believed to bring overall well-being. They include stories of heroism of low caste men and women. Next point is that Bengali architecture. Caste men and women Bengali. There were migration of peoples from the less fertile West Bengal to the forested areas of southeastern Bengal. During the 16th century, as people moved eastwards, they brought the land under rice cultivation by clearing the forests. These coincided with the establishment of Mughal control over Bengal with their capital and Dhaka as officials. And the functionaries received land grants. They often set up mashups that served as the centers for religious transformations. In these areas, tribal traditions influenced the architectural style of temple. Building temple building in Bengal during the medieval period. Tribal deities were often worshipped. ये जो ट्राइब्स थे वो भी वहाँ पे वर्शिप के लिए जाते थे. इन द सेला थैच्ड श्रीन्स वेयर हिंदूज वर्शिप्ड दीज डेटीज दे प्लेस द इमेज. थैच मतलब जो रूफ होता है वो ऊपर का. दे प्लेस द इमेजेस इन द टेम्पल्स रिजेम्बलिंग द चालीस श्रीन सच एज द टेम्पल हैड द स्लोपिंग रूफ विच लुक लाइक आइदर अ dosa with the roof made of four pieces of thatch. Some of the best examples of Bangla style temples are found in Vishnu in the Bunkers district of West Bengal. Among these are Radhar B. Nerd and the Kisteria temples. The Kisteria temples, red soil of Vishnu, is excellent for making the terracotta bricks and the sculptures. The temples of Vishnu have beautiful terracotta bands on their walls fish. Next is that fish in Bengal. How we are eating the food? So what is the Bengali culture? Bengali culture traditional food habits are generally based on locally available food items. Much of Bengal river is Rhine plain, which produces plenty of rice and fish. Hence, fish is an important item in the डेली डाइट. हमारे यहाँ पे जैसे रोटी सब्जी होती है वैसे वहाँ पे डेली लाइफ में फिश होता है. पीपल ऑफ बंगाल फ्रॉम ऑल सेक्शंस ऑफ बंगाली सोसाइटी ईट फिश इवन ब्राह्मीन्स. अनलाइक द ब्राह्मीन्स इन द मोस्ट पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया आर अलाउड टू ईट वाइट फिश. मतलब ब्राह्मण लोगों को वाइट फिश खाने के लिए अलाउड है. With the scales fishing has always been important occupation. तो बंगाल में occupation भी उनका वही है. So people of the Bengal and Bengali literature contains several references of fish. Besides serving as a food, regarded as the specious and are used in the ceremonies and rituals. Fish are depicted in the sculptures, paintings, and alfanas. Alfanas folk art from forms in which designs are drawn on the floor with the powder of rice. फ्लोवर त्रिविया, कैट अकाली, अ क्लासिकल डांस फ्रॉम केरला. दिस डांस फॉर्म हैज़ अ यूनिक ब्लेंड ऑफ लिटरेचर, म्यूजिक, पेंटिंग, एक्टिंग एंड डांस गोथिक. लिटरेरी मीन्स स्टोरी, प्ले त्रिविया. पहाड़ी पेंटिंग इज एन अम्ब्रेला टर्म यूज्ड फॉर अ फॉर्म ऑफ पेंटिंग दैट फ्लोरिश्ड इन द माउंटेनियस रीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. इट वॉज मोस्टली डन इन अ मिनिएचर फॉर्म बट प्रेजेंट्स ग्रेट वेरिएशंस इन स्टाइल. सो आई होप स्टूडेंट्स यू अंडरस्टूड ऑल द लेसन ऑफ द मेकिंग ऑफ रीजनल कल्चर्स.